And welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this particular video, I'm going to show you how to bring in your phone camera to OBS using the Arium webcam. Now, I've shared a previous video on how you can bring in your phone camera to OBS using a new tech NDI app. You can also check that video out, but in this particular video, I'm going to show you how to bring in your phone camera to OBS using the Arium webcam. Now, the best part about using the Arium webcam is that it's 100% free, so you're not paying any dime both on their software and also their mobile app as well. And another thing also is it allows you to scale up your phone camera quality to 4K. So even if your phone camera is not up to 4K quality, don't worry, you'll still be able to scale it up to 4K and it will come out clean, just like what you're seeing right there on the screen. I've been able to bring in my phone camera to OBS using the Arium webcam software, and I can scale this to 4K quality, full HD, depending on whichever resolution I want to. You see, from here click on video format and you can select whichever format you want. If you want to select the 4K, if you want to select the full HD, whichever one you want to make use of. So you are in charge and you can select whichever resolution you want to make use of on OBS, just as you are seeing right there on the screen. And now the best part also is if the Arium webcam is not only sending only the video feed to your OBS, it's also sending along the audio feed to OBS. So it's sending both the video and the audio feed to OBS so that you can also get to hear the sound and you can stream this live on YouTube and Facebook as well using OBS. And this is what I'm going to show you in this particular video. Without any further ado, let me show you how to bring in your phone camera to OBS using the Arium webcam. Now, everything is 100% free, both their app and also their software, so you're not paying any dime for it. Don't worry, let me show you how to get it done. Okay, now I'm just going to go ahead and close all of these and also close this one too. Okay, so let's close this one too. Now open your browser, whichever one you are making use of, so be it Chrome, Firefox, whichever one you're using. Okay, and type in Arium webcam. I've also left the link in the description below, so you can also click on that link and download the Arium webcam. And from here you can see the Arium webcam for Windows, go ahead and download it. And also for, if you're using Mac, go ahead and also download the Arium webcam for Mac. And you see that for Ubuntu too, go ahead and also download it for Ubuntu. But if you're using Windows, just click on this and you'll be able to download the Arium webcam software. Now, once you've downloaded the Arium webcam, let me show you how to install it on your PC. And you can connect up to 4 phones. Okay, you can connect up to 4 phones using the Arium webcam, and you can scale them to 4K, all of them individually. Okay, so let me show you how to install it. Go ahead and open your file explorer here, go to download. Let me just expand this so that you can see it. Open program and let's look for the Arium webcam. You can see it here, this is the Arium webcam. So once you're here, right click and select open. Okay, so you can select open or you can select run as administrator, whichever one you select is still fine. Okay, and from here you can see the number of camera down there. From here, the number of camera, select 4. If you want to bring in more camera, you select 4. Okay, so if you want to bring only one phone camera, you select 1, but I advise you select 4 because you might want to bring in more phones to your OBS live stream later on. Okay, so just select 4 so you won't have to reinstall and uninstall it again. Okay, so just click on next here, and once you're done, click on next and hit the install button, and this will install the Arium webcam. Now after you finish installing your Arium webcam on your PC, make sure that your phone and your PC are connected to the same Wi-Fi. Okay, so make sure that the two of them are connected to the same Wi-Fi. And after you finish installing the software, go over to your Google Play Store. So go over to your Play Store here, so just watch my phone screen there. Go over to your Play Store and search for Arium webcam. Okay, Arium webcam, you can see the Arium 4K webcam for PC and Mac. Okay, so go ahead and install it, and once you finish installing it, open it. But before any of this, remember what I said, make sure that your phone and your PC are connected to the same net Wi-Fi. So if they are not connected to the same Wi-Fi, it's not going to work. Okay, you're not going to see anything. Now, because during the installation process we selected four number of cameras, we selected 4, so right click on the Arium webcam on your PC, just right click on that to open it, and once it has opened, you are going to see your phone there. Okay, you can see my phone there. Let me just hang this here just 1 second, and once you have, okay, you can see my phone right there on the screen. And from here, let's click on the 3-dot line. See, the video format is on automatic. You can remove it from there and put it on 4K if you want to. see the improvement now. Put it on 4K if you want to, or you can change it to full HD, which is 1080 if you also want to. And once you've done all of this, you see the camera too. That is, if you want to bring in more phone, all you have to do is to install the Iridium webcam on that new phone that you want to bring in to the software. Okay, so install the Iridium webcam on the second phone and also connect all of them to you, or to the same Wi-Fi you use on your system. So connect all of them, both your system and all the phones, to the same Wi-Fi and install Iridium webcam on them. Open them and you're going to be seeing them individually right here. All the phones that are connected to the same Wi-Fi with your system, you're going to see all of them right here. Now take note of the number. This is the camera one, okay, which is the one that currently have an active feed. The camera two is blank and the camera three is also blank as well. Okay, so I'm just going to minimize this. Go ahead and open your OBS studio. Okay, so let's open our OBS studio. Just 1 second, and you can see it here. I'm just going to close this. Let me close this one. And once you've opened your OBS studio, let me just close this. Once you've opened your OBS studio, click on the add button here on the sources. Click on the add button and select video capture device. So select the video capture device. Once you click on the video capture device, let's name this webcam one. Just name it webcam. Okay, so let's name it webcam and click on OK. Now once it opens, you see the device there. It's already on NewTek NDI video. Don't worry, just click on it and select the Iridium webcam. See, this one that doesn't have number is number one. So if you select number two, it's not going to work. Remember from here that number two has no active video feed. You see, the 2, 3, 4 has no video feed. So don't select any of this number. Make sure you select this first one that doesn't have number, Iridium webcam. It represents one, okay, because that is the one that currently have an active video feed. So that if you select two, it will not work, it will not show. If you select three, it will not show. To select four, it will not show because they don't have any video feed. Now select this one here, select it, and once you've selected, you can see. So as you can see right there, it's currently showing. Okay, so that is it. And from here, don't worry, you've already configured the resolution on the Iridium webcam. See, from here you've already selected the resolution you want to. Okay, so no need to do any setting here. Okay, so leave it as audio output. See, you also capture audio also. So click on OK. And the Iridium webcam will send both the audio and video feed from your phone to your PC. Let's bring this in on full screen. Now, if you want to retouch it, maybe work on the saturation or anything, place your mouse on it and right click, okay, and select filters. Okay, select the filters, and once it opens, let me reduce this so that you can see what I'm doing. Click on this plus button here and the effect filters. So click on it and select the color correction. So once you're on the color correction, click on OK and increase the saturation. If you want to increase the saturation a little bit, you can work on the gamma. Maybe if you want it to be bright, maybe brighter, anything you want. The brightness, if you want it to be bright, if you want to increase it, you want to lower it, anyone you want. And the contrast, so whichever one you want, you can also select that. And once you're done, click on OK, and you can see how it came out clean. And this is how to connect your phone camera to OBS using the Iridium webcam.